Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Brent Foster, and today we are going to be playing Rocket League, where every Tuesday we play Rocket League. We call it Rocket League Today, and we talk about different stuff that comes to my mind. Okay, I got some different things today to talk about. First of all, I'm gonna get the difficult stuff out of the way first. There was a whole bunch of Nintendo trademarks that just showed up, and I thought they were very interesting, so I'm going to talk about those trademarks. One of them is the Smash logo. Now, we know that Smash is going to show off at E3. They're going to have a big old tournament and stuff like that, so yeah, that's pretty cool. I'm sure they're not going to call it Smash 4 or Smash 5. I'm pretty sure they're going to call it Smash for Switch. Okay, another trademark is Star Fox, which I think is very interesting because the last Star Fox we had was for the Wii U. It was called Star Fox Zero, and it didn't get great reviews. But I would like to see it come back in a big way and change up the formula and, you know, look a lot better on the Switch. Another thing, trademark that popped up is for F-Zero. That franchise has been dead for a long time, so to see it come back would be really great. You have these cars that can hover above the road, and you're driving really, really fast. The one I played was the Game Boy Advance version. The F-Zero one, that's pretty much the only one I played. But I'd like to experience it in, on the Switch. Okay, another trademark they filed was for Pikmin. A while ago, Nintendo said they were working on Pikmin 4, and then it was almost ready. But we haven't heard anything about Pikmin 4 for a long time, so I think it's about time to hear something about it. Now, there's no guarantee that these are going to be games, but they're still interesting to talk about, nonetheless. Another one we have is Yoshi's Island. The last Yoshi's Island was, I believe, Yoshi's New Island for the Nintendo 3DS. I don't prefer it. I don't have a lot to say about it. I did like the older ones a lot better, though. But, yeah, that would be cool to see it come back. Okay. Got some other trademarks here. The Legendary Starfy. I've only played that on the DS one time. You're this star and it's platforming, but it's like underwater and stuff. So yeah, that was an odd one to come up with. Okay, another odd one. These ones were all Wii games, so I was surprised when these popped up. Wii Fit, Wii Music, Wii Play, and Wii Sports. Maybe they're bringing the Virtual Console, the Wii games, but it's not called the Virtual Console, or they're just gonna throw them on the Switch eShop. I don't know. They also have Link's Crossbow Training, which is a really odd one. Okay, the other news that I want to talk about is Retro, the team that made Donkey Kong Returns and Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze, and also the Metroid Prime series 1 and 2, are supposed to be rumored to be making a new Star Fox game, entitled Star Fox Racing. So yeah, that's a weird one. Oh, that is some new stuff. I'm not done yet. I was still talking, so we're going to make the video go a little bit longer than normal. Okay, Star Fox Racing. I've played Star Fox Adventure and Star Fox Assault. Star Fox Adventure was an adventure platformer kind of game, and it reminded me a lot of Zelda games, which was pretty cool. I like the graphics a lot. So, there's that. Then we have Star Fox Assault, which came out for the GameCube as well. It was more of a third-person view, and you got like a rocket launcher, a gun, or some kind of weapon like that. And you run around the area shooting bad guys and stuff. You also had missions where you can jump into the cockpit and fly around and shoot down enemies, battle bosses, navigate through treacherous terrain and stuff like that. So that was a cool one. I like Star Fox Assault. So Star Fox Racing, what do I think of that kind of game? I don't know. I guess maybe, what if your vehicle could transform? You could have like a tank, or it could turn into an F-Zero like car, and then a plane. You could have different terrain, I guess. You could fly in the sky sometimes. My thing about this is it's an on-rail shooter. How are they going to do it? How are they going to make a racing game an on-rail shooter? Or not? They have to put some kind of shooting element in it, because that's what Star Fox is about. It's about flying around and shooting stuff. So we'll see what happens there. I think that's all we're going to talk about for today. If you like what you see, don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you later. Bye!